We are back in Resident Evil 7. I'm going to take her with some more settings today to try and reduce the stuttering, lag, and sync drifting bullshit that I've been getting. So we shall see how we got on. This is good, a little. What we have to do this part is find the fuse. Oh! Wait, did we do this last time? Have I picked the wrong save? See what now? Oh no, we just did this. Yeah, because this is the... Oh god, David, seriously? Right, so this is a shortcut then. We can actually go up. Nope, that's where we saw the thing. I should... Seriously, David, remember this shit. Okay. I do hear some stuff. We actually want to go this... Whoa. Oh, god, that... Hi. Hi. Ah, so as I was testing settings today, I actually found it's fairly easy to kill Mr. Jack. But the, oh shit, okay, maybe not a good idea. Really? Oh. Right. Ah, okay. Oh shit! Oh shit! Okay, we're good, we're good. Oh! Damn. I was hoping that was gonna use one of those just to give us the oh wow. I actually wasn't expecting that to open. Amazon River Cruise Guide, Beauty and the Black Lagoon, or in the Black Lagoon. Oh, hello. God damn it. Dear Janet, hey, how's it going? I guess half a year or so will have passed by the time you get this letter. Life is so boring here, day after day, just the same old sea. Although there is one thing that is different. This time we have passengers sailing with us, which hardly ever happens. It's a couple with a little girl. I think they're distant relatives of the captain. Imagine travelling on a tanker instead of a passenger ship. They must be hard up. I tried talking to the little girl earlier and her dad shot me this nasty look. What's he so worried about? Now that I think about it, the captain said he didn't even have any relatives. Maybe I'm overthinking this. I miss you. Love, Jim. So there's something fishy going on. It's too late for us, but at least I can let the world know what happened here. I was on the night shift yesterday, so I was taking a nap in the bunk room around noon. I was half asleep and I heard a kid, a little girl, laughing, or was it all in my head? I woke up at 7:30. There was some sort of ruckus in the passageway. Drew, one of the engineers, came in and said there was something going on down below. Maybe a riot. He looked pale in the face. He told me he was going down to check it out, but never came back. It must have been around 10:08 when I heard the scream. I went to the laundry room to check and saw Clark being eaten by some sort of blackish monster. The monster turned and started coming towards me, huge shark-like teeth snapping in its jaw. I just screamed like a little girl and ran for it. Okay, what I do. Now I'm huddled up in the bunk room, shaking as I write this. There's a whole host of these creatures lurking in the passageways now. I can hear screams now and then, but there's no way I'm going to get out there now. And that's it. I've written everything I know. Giovanni Vannetti. He was on the crew list, wasn't he? Obviously. Right, psychostimulants. Nicely done. If I do say so myself. Which I absolutely do. Ah, okay, so I've kind of came the long way around. But that's good, because that gets us back up there with the fuses. Oh. That's scary. That's where the fuse door. Yep, okay. So I think we're good here then. Yeah. How's about? Alright, sure. Ooh, fuck, I didn't like it. Oh, hi. Lewis. The cable's completely fried. We had a replacement, but we had to use it to fix something in third floor sickbay. Gonna have to go and ask Dr. Waddle for it. I'm in need down in number 2 engine room, but I can't get down unless we get this thing working. Alright, so first of all, let's stick the fuse in. Not that we need the room, but... So third floor sickbay, yeah? Let's go try the third floor sickbay. Fucking hear those things everywhere, you know, it's not very nice. Oh god. Do we really have to? Oh no, we don't. Okay. Ah! That was weird. I can't tell what's ambience and what's fucking high. Yeah, it helps if you actually take the headshots, I think. Do I have a lockpick? No. I'm going to use some things. No. But there's obviously shit. Oh, holy fuck. Oh, God. Don't come out the toilet. Aha. Thank you. Ah, there's the cable. Then shit hits the fan. Okay. Long as I know. Gonna have to do that, I'm afraid. And then I'm gonna do that. And make one of those bad boys. That's gonna... Oh wow, that doesn't even lock from this side. Okay. That's harsh. Okay. Let's take this, shall we? Is that really a thing you're doing right now? Oh, shit! They obviously foresaw people doing this. Okay. Let's not fight him. Apparently he's fast. Yes, thank you. All right. We should be good, right? Holy Holy mother fuck. Alright, I'm not gonna put that in yet because I don't know if that's gonna like take the lift straight down, but this big motherfucker actually like here now. Oh, holy hell. That might actually be worth taking that. Right, good. We've made a little bit of progress then. Save it. I don't fancy taking one of those on with just a pistol. No! No! Okay. Where the fuck do we need to go? I think the only one we haven't been to is the fourth floor. That was blocked off, wasn't it? Am I wrong? We have been here. Oh, I'm so fucking lost. Hold on, let's go in here. Yeah, we've been there. Haven't we? Yeah, we've been there. Have we been all the way down to S2? Okay, let's try it. I can hear him squelching. He needs to... That was weird.
He's waiting.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. I don't have the shit for this! God damn you. Yeah, hi. Fuck. Just in the nick of time, right? Oh god. Okay. All right. Fucking. We're not cut out for this. I'm not that worried about you. Can't open doors. So we're fine. Oh. Mm-hmm. I'm stuck. Helps. Oh, whew. This handgun's actually pretty good. Oh. Yeah, how's about no fucking thank you? See ya. Oh. I don't much like this much. Oh, yay! Hang on a minute. Okay. Something will drop down behind me here. It's too enclosed not to take that opportunity. Oh, really? Nice!
Ethan.
Ethan. Ethan. Hey, shh, shh. I know. I'm not gonna hurt you. Hell, I never would have if I could have helped it.
What do you mean?
Oh,
I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas, or even Zoe here. That girl, Evelyn, she did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it. I found her busted out tanker in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son. She just... She forces her way into your mind, your soul. You can't fight back. You are connected to her, and you can't resist the urge to... You're a different person after that.
I never thought you'd feel sorry for him.
So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn.
Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key. All right? You find her, and you stop her. Ethan. Free my family. Please.
Poor Jack. God, I never thought you'd. The fuckers.
Stay away from him.
Why? He doesn't love you. I can make him love you.
Don't hurt him.
Silly, I told you I'm not gonna hurt him.
Don't you dare.
So what? You're not my mom. Remember?
Oh, that came back to bite you in the arse.
Mia, how?
There's no time. You have to get out of here and find her. Here, take this.
What? Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Saving your life. You need to go. I won't be able to resist for much longer.
No. I cured you.
Now go kill that little bitch.
No.
Mia!
Right, no! I'm confuzzled. Is she infected again? So I completely wasted that. I'd have been better off using it on fucking Zoe then. I was saying that same thing probably.
Okay,
I don't know.
Bitch. Where the fuck are you?
It's all your fault. I thought it said it's not my fault a second ago. Into the depths we go. Right. So I don't even have a knife. This is harsh. Don't do it. I saw something bubble. So from what I saw, the ship is actually called, I saw it from someone else's video, obviously I haven't watched ahead, just watched up to where I stopped, In fact, probably before that, I think their video had... Anyway. The ship's called the Annabelle. So it's not the Queen Zenobia. Ah. Ooh. Abercrombie Salt Mine, South Dalvey. February 1892, there was a collapse in the Patterson Mine. Turn, Tew and Beckford are dead. Huxley will never walk on his own again. Old Man Stan was right. The ground here or there is too unstable. The 19th. The company's not going to send us any replacements. They want us to work double shifts instead. I can't wait to get back to the old country. Are they watching us from that helicopter? Yeah. Please see, you've taken me as things. Die, bitch, and give me your supplies. Right, okay. That was harsh. So let's... I think Mia's knife might be better than ours. Survival knife, so we'll take that. Standard her. So it's just the same as the old handgun then. But we'll take our M19. We shall take... And there's a fucking... You can take the broken shotgun. I don't know these things. Hang on. No. We can't have that there. Do we have any more magnum bullets? Got a shitload of handgun ammo though, that's good. But yeah, you can get a double barrel shotgun. By taking the model shotgun and replacing it with the broken shotgun, and then you find another repair kit. I found that sitting playing with Eric, watching him play some of this last night. Feel like a dumb shit. Hey ho, what can you do? We'll take that. We'll take those. We'll take the corrosives as well, I would imagine. Definitely gonna take first aid. Yeah, that looks good for just now. Saving. Woo! Oh, okay. Steroids. Oh, the magnum we got. Yeah.
Alpha 1, this is Bravo 1. Do you read?
This is Alpha 1. Report. Did you find anything?
A thorough search of the Baker property revealed zero survivors. Repeat, zero survivors. We did find evidence of a skirmish.
Evelyn?
Negative. However, we did find several encrypted messages from the Baker's son, Lucas, to an unknown third party. You can probably guess who that was.
That's just great. We've had reports using the abandoned mine south of the property. I'm gonna go have a look.
Roger that. We'll meet you at those coordinates.
If you encounter Evelyn, orders are shoot to kill. Repeat. Shoot to kill.
Don't shoot my wifey though. Alright, okay. Yeah, like we're gonna hump that around. Wait, excuse me? Oh. I confused myself there, I get quite disorientated. Haha! Haha! Good. Fine and good shit, guys. Let's do this, motherfuckers. Yep. What the fuck you got, huh? Fuck! Doing it again. There. Yeah. They always do that little shimmy just at the last second. There. Okay. Good. Sorted. Dead. Fuck you. I need to remember there's more handgun ammo in that chest. I realised that was a lot of ammo I just wasted, but I did it with the hopes that I would find some good shit here. And we found some shit. Yeah, they're setting us up. From what I understand, I'm pretty close to the end though. I left Eric last night. He made a different choice and picked Zoe, so I was worried about things being different, and I left before he'd finished. And when we spoke today, he said he finished it today. So yeah, I can't be too far from the end. And I know Matt was saying after the ship, you're kind of relatively close to the end as well. So, wow, we got some good shit here. Wow, we have no room left. Shit. Okay. I'm gonna make one regular. I'm gonna make one small. Strong. I'm gonna keep that other one for maybe some grenade rounds. And I'm gonna keep that one for some handgun bullets if we need them. I think that sounds like quite a good plan. Shame you can't make shotgun shells. It's definitely a shame. Let's do this. I need to remember that you can guard rather than just let enemies hit you full force. We are going fucking deep. Oh, this is like Outlast. There's obviously been a lot of comparisons to Outlast, but this is, I mean, it's a mine, you know, so it's not. It's obviously not like they ripped off, it just looks very similar. I hate the little aha. What's his name? They did say he was here, so. Ah. We're gonna have to start shooting boxes again. Fuck. What? Oh shit! Maybe that was, yeah, the thing that happened. Me, that scared the shit out of me. Hopefully we find another item box soon. I need a handgun ammo. Oh man. Oh. Holy fuck. I think we might have to. We've got the room apparently. This. Ow. I think there might be another one. No, it's just you. How are you not? How is that not dead? I don't know. Maybe I'm. Because those ones are smaller, getting the headshots might look like a headshot, it's not a headshot, you know, I don't know. But those ones seem to go down a lot quicker. So I don't see how they are the easier of the. They're the hard, maybe the harder, stronger of the enemy. Oh, Oh, fucking shit. I think it goes down in one hit. Come on now. Not that I'm saying it's a bad game. Please don't get me wrong. It's great. I absolutely love it so far. Just find it. You know, some things are a bit... Oh my god. Oh wait, now I feel dumb. I probably could have just done that and ran them over and saved the bullets. Rather up here, no boulders that we're going to have to run away from. Aww. Missed the trick there, Capcom. Okay, no loot there, that's fine. Definitely got a more combat based six. Bastards. Yeah, well played. Wait a minute, what? I thought it was Grandma over there. Wait, did I craft shit? I did, so... I'm fine. Friday, January 16th. Thanks to you guys, it's been about a week since my head's been clear and back to normal, and she still thinks she's got me. You guys really need to work on fixing that. Not only does she look like a little kid, but she's about as stupid as one too. Mum and Dad are still totally under, though. I was wondering, is this whole family obsession something you guys programmed into? It's kind of fucked up. That bitch Mia is still somewhere between Evie La La Land and reality. She gets pretty violent, so I locked her up in the cell. I thought maybe Evelyn would get mad since Mia's her favourite and all, but she doesn't seem to care. She actually goes and visits her sometimes. She thinks Mia's her mummy. And I said, your bioweapon... Like I said, your bioweapon is fucked up. Evelyn's family obsession is getting out of hand. She's making everyone kidnap more and more arseholes off the street to add to her freak show of a family. Maybe she's getting tired of Mia not coming around, but it's a pain in the ass for me because I got to clean up the mess whenever someone new comes along. By the way, Evie's looking sick or something. Her skin's getting all wrinkly and she's getting grey hairs. Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. Evie's grandma? Holy shit, I was right in the beginning. And it was only because I had no idea who Evie was supposed to be. So he locked her... Oh my god, right. So Mia's been locked up for quite a while then. Ten minutes after dose death. E neurotoxin, E series dosage test. 5 minutes after dose, vomiting. Tomasero cell clarification. Have we got another? Select item to use. Hang on, whoa. E necrotoxins or destroy cells of any subject based in the EC's. Okay. So this will kill Evie. Can we use a corrosive on it? No. Okay. What do we need? Okay. So we need something, obviously. Evelyn's functions also include the ability to form organisms from mycelia, the fungal filaments. The term organism is used loosely here. Strictly speaking, they are superorganisms formed of countless mycelia. What's important, though, is that they exhibit a strong survival instinct and will defend themselves ferociously with the slightest provocation. Their fungal toughness and remarkable strength give them significant battlefield potential. The usual bullshit. The researchers have been calling these superorganisms the Molded, made of mold and also molded as in shaped. The name has a certain elegance to it. For the treatment of accidental infections, performing on samples of Evelyn's body tissue produces a unique fungicidal serum. Administering the serum as to an infected subject will cause the micelle to calcify, but if the subject's cells are already largely invaded, the serum will be fatal. Since the treatment window is so small, the serum's primary use therefore dispose of infected subjects rather than cure. In exploring the serum's potential, we found that subject to A would enhance its effects of extreme potency, becoming a compound we know as E-neurotoxin, which and even tiny mouse. What's been interesting to observe is Evelyn's behaviour with her obsession with the concept of family. The experiments we found on multiple occasions that the infected subjects were compelled to act as her mother or father, treating her as if they were really her daughter. Why did she settle upon family as a theme for her mind control? This is just speculation, but it could be that she instinctively understands that family units better suited to blending social groups than a lone girl. On the other hand, well, a sentimental sort might suggest that she's making up for a perceived lack of love in her quarantined upbringing, a parent's love. Ah, you try to make us feel sorry for the little whore. It's now apparently an old woman. Hi, safe room. Right. I think we'll dump this. I think we will take these. We never got the machine gun. Whoops. Wow. Do we need this? Okay, so we are going to need it at some point then. We'll put these away. I'm kind of hesitant to put this away because... So I'll put this away. Make sure we're fully loaded on that shit. We'll pop around in this just in case. Yeah, we're fully loaded. Let's go. Whew, that would have been good. Let's forget to save. Yay! Okay, right. Let's go. Wait, what? But there was only... Wait, what? Alright, okay. Oh, whoa, I'm so stupid. Duh. So I bet you now we can progress. Wait, is this going to be like the final boss battle? Oh fuck, I'm scared. I'm scared. I'm going to put the psychosocials away. Oh, what else to put away? I'm going to put away the 10 bullets because it's things. I'm going to equip. Ah, wow, I'm really scared of what's coming up now. That's handgun ammo. But that's not a hint. But wait, surely we'll have to take down Lucas first. I mean, he's like a loose end we haven't tied up yet, isn't he? Yeah, because the hints are there because she's been singing that song. Yeah, the old lady was even singing that song. Hello. Okay. Wait. Oh shit. Should I run? Okay, let's. Well, that one didn't have any arms. That was helpful. Shit. Missed. Oh, come on! Oh, I hate those things. I fucking detest them. I hate little scootery bastards. Oh, fuck off. Fuck. Yeah, bleh yourself. Very handy, very good, very good. Climb. Okay. All right. Let's just take a moment to Right, now something's gonna go pop. Also surprised it hasn't. Salt mine, huh? Okay. Alright, so this must be it. Let's go. Every night, I tell you, she knows. Wee! No fucking wee! Fucking.
It's not here. It's gone. It's gone!
Hang on a sec. Back. Sorry about that. Oh yeah, that's Evelyn. So that is fucking Evelyn. All right, so we can't explore this way then, right? Okay. So we've come full circle. Why?
This is your fault.
How's it my fault?
Why am I saying this?
Oh, fuck. Am I infected? Bye. Can I play the piano now? Right, okay, I'm obviously gonna have to go and do the thing.
Ethan, it's okay. It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
Kill him, Mommy.
Oh, but you shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
He doesn't want to be my daddy? Then he can die. Now it's Mommy's turn to kill you.
Oh, fuck. I don't know whereabouts in the house to go. Oh, they took the save point away.
Help.
Alright, so that's one way, so wonder what happens. Oh, I farted, sorry. Okay. Why are you being a whore?
You're gonna be one of us. And then maybe you'll play nicely.
I'm not playing.
No! Get that away from me!
Don't need your pity!
Huh? I'm so confused! So you just like... The hell are you? Oh, so that was a waste of a shotgun shell. Horrendous. Wait, you pointing at something? No. I don't know where to go. I heard help up here, so I kind of want to help. But then I thought that was maybe... What? Okay.
All right. Stay away!
Oops.
Stay back.
No, I will not stay back, thank you very much.
Get away!
Ah. Oh, yes, I do.
Get away from me! Stop! Stop! No! No, no, no!
Yeah, I was right! See, she was starving.
It hurts. I'm melting.
Oh fuck, this isn't good. Wait. Okay. Just hold on. Well, I figure out the clunky infantry system. Sometimes it doesn't work, obviously. Fail. Whoops. Get it. Punk, is that you? I'll take Albert. Weird. Fucking. Is this an umbrella helicopter? I'm scared. I'm wearing my umbrella t-shirt. Hi. Wait, have I done something? No, okay.
Redfield. I'm glad we found you.
The fuck took you guys so long?
There you go. He's there. He's fucking always there. No, right away. I like the look of that, Chris. That's a much better... That's obviously Chris. Yeah. Unless it's a third brother or a third sibling.
You made it. I'm glad.
He's,
Did I?
I really like the new look. Looks less action hero, more just... dude.
They say that when one door closes, another opens. Well, a door closed tonight. And what a long night it was. But not just for me. Me and I weren't the only victims here. So were the Bakers. It was that thing, Evelyn, who made them that way. But now Evelyn's dead. And these guys are here to clean up the mess. I had just come to terms with losing But now she's back and wants to start over. Put all this behind us. Maybe this is where the next door opens.
But why is Chris Redfield in an umbrella helicopter? Well, we did it. I wonder if there's a results screen, old school stylee. See how bad I was at the game. Like 0.25% accuracy and shit. Wait, what the fuck? Oh, okay. Credits. Okay. I loved it. Yeah. It was great. It was what Resident Evil needed, which is to go way back to the horror style. I'm very pleased. There was the issues. It wasn't perfect by any means. I think the pacing was pretty good. Just when you kind of thought or got to that point of thinking, right, okay, yeah, Jack's there. He's, you know, then they throw the molded at you, and it's like, oh, okay, so there's that kind of almost like Nemesis style where there's the constant threat that's just going to stalk you but can't really be permanently taken down for the most part. And then there's the molded, which can be. The atmosphere was great, especially the beginning parts of the game. The ship was actually really atmospheric too. Favourite section was probably the happy birthday tape and the kind of haunted house with the balls flying around where you get the D-arm. The atmosphere there was particularly nice. Just enough nods to the classic Resident Evil. The balance between new and old was quite good, I thought. It was disgusting as well. I think what made it so, I mean, from the get-go, when you're in that first sequence with Mia, it's just so vicious. There was just something about the way it was done so well that you actually felt as though you could feel her stabbing you. It was just done really well. I'm really curious though to see if there is a results screen. Oh, Madhouse mode will be coming. Me and Eric were talking, and we're going to race Madhouse difficulty. And we've obviously found the previous races. Most of them have ended up binned because someone lost the footage or someone shut down their channel. Not me. I lost the footage. But these very hard difficulties sometimes show the flaws in games, so we'll see if that's the same case here. But yeah, we'll be doing that fairly soon. I would say but we did it. I was brave for the most part. Maybe cheese the odd save room here and there, but that's allowed, right? Always get the credits in. Yeah, definitely think they nailed it. Unfortunately, I had the technical difficulties. I hope I caught most of it, but it was drifting in and out of sync. Eric was having the same issue, although not as bad as me. I was having some times where it was like taking hours to edit an episode, just trying to sync it all up, so it might not be perfect, but I did do my best. But I think I finally sorted it for tonight, so duh. Good to know for the future though, right? ResidentEvil.net. I had a funny feel, but I wonder what that means. Chris Redfield obviously turned up at the end there, but he's in an umbrella helicopter. What does that mean? He's not jump side, surely. But then umbrella are supposed to be shut down, gone, kaput. Nice little twist, though. Chris Redfield. That fucker's always creeping up. To be fair though, could have been Leon. I wouldn't have been surprised either. Although Ada would have had to have been in tow somewhere. But yeah, a lot of people obviously complaining that, but it's not classic Resident Evil characters. Good. They were getting boring. Nice wee nod at the end there, fine. But they were getting fucking boring and that was the thing. That's why it had to become the kind of action game it was, because the combat in this was just the right amount of awkward. I thought that it was believable that you weren't some specially trained fucking soldier, basically. And that's what Chris and Leon and the rest of them classic characters are now. So it's very hard to, you know, kind of come up with that situation where, apart from them maybe being captured, you know, there's ways they could have done it, but I do like that they started it with a fresh story and fresh characters. Just my opinion. Original Force. Technicolor animation. Well, yeah, overall, I'm pleased. Wonder what they're going to do with Resident Evil 8, because you know they're not going to stop here. I just hope they see that this has been so much more favorably reviewed. I hope the sales are much better than 5 and 6. I really do, because I hope this is the nod or the push they need to realize, okay, the horror is more important. The horror is where people want to go, and that's what people are going to buy, and they stick to this. Not maybe not necessarily keep it first person all the time. I mean, I'd be totally fine with that, but, you know, keep the horror of the focus, not the action, because it's definitely much better. And then they kind of started to do that with Revelations 1 and 2. 2 more than 1. I thought 2 was much better than Revelations 1. But Revelations was better than anything that had been released for years as well, because they tried to focus a bit more on, you know, claustrophobic areas and, you know, not to the extent this did, obviously, but, you know, more so than 5 and 6. It's like, the funny thing about 6 is it, like, tried at the very beginning for the first 10 minutes, like, ooh, spooky place, zombies, and ooh, and then it was like, ah, fuck it, let's just have fucking helicopters flying and dodging trains and can, so bad. So bad. One day I will get Eric to play it on No Hope Left. Just saying. Go tell Aunt Rhody. Traditional with new music and lyrics by Michael Levine. Or Levin. Yeah, Levine. Lead vocals. Oh, I can't read it. Voice recording unit. Ooh. I like that effect on that guitar, it's nice. Oh, now we're getting metal. Yeah. Oh, okay. We're maybe going to Madhouse tonight, but Eric's just messaging me saying he's going to his bed, so we will Madhouse tomorrow. Oh, are we getting a bass solo? These are a lot of credits. I wonder if they ever really are as long as they seem, and it's just because I'm recording and seriously running out of things to talk about while they run across. So yeah, this is probably going to be an extra long episode. Now, what do I record now? I mean, I know I've got stuff I haven't finished, but... Oh, Camp Sunshine. Still to finish that. Xenoverse. Stuff. Oh, we're at the special thanks section, guys. That usually means we're nearly finished. Yeah, here's the big, shit. Original Force. Let's see it. Let's see you, Capcom. One thing I will point out, or will kind of note on, when you think of the game as a whole, it's actually very short. Think about it. You've got your kind of intro sequence, then you get to the house, then you have the Mia sequence where you fight Mia, then you wake up, then you're stalked by Jack, you've taken three dog heads, you get the three dog heads, you're out the front. When you're out the front, you're then going into the house of Marguerite, then you fight Marguerite, then you fight Bug Marguerite, then you have to get the key cards, then you get the key cards, then you get, you know, through all that section with Lucas, and then you're kind of at the closing stages with the ship and shit. So, whatever. Whatever happened to Lucas? I can't remember. We didn't kill him, did we? There they are, the Bakers. I do like the way they made you feel sorry for them at the end when you realise they've just been manipulated like that. Hello? I actually thought that was my phone. Okay, 757. Wow, that's actually pretty good. I mean, I was powering through it right enough. Right. So, 13 restarts. Whoopsies. I think about 10 of them were fighting Jack. Mr. Everywhere Destroyed, so I missed 9 of those. I only missed 5 antique coins. Files I missed 5 of. Item box open 58. Healing I used 42. Stabilizers used 0. Steroids used 2. Difficulty for this saved here. Okay. Hour 1 will be added to the item box in the main game. Oh, okay. So there's a few extra. Oh, cool. Right, oh no, but it looks as if it's just going to be Resident Evil 6 again. Oh, don't spoil it with the first DLC, guys. Oh well, we'll see how that goes. But yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I will see you probably in Madhouse. Thanks then. Bye. Oh, shit! No! I don't like it.